Hello, 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 Facebook, 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 Facebook. I have to respond to a video posted by askamuslim.com on Facebook. Now, the man of Bible, I think in Columbus, Ohio, something like that. The man of Bible, they say Jesus is a Muslim. Look at this blaspheme. Look at this blaspheme. And they say Jesus is a Muslim. Yes, he's a Muslim. He's a worshiper of Allah. He's a servant of Allah. That's what they say. Jesus Christ is serving Allah. Now, that's a blaspheme. The difference between Allah and Jesus is. Let me tell you something. I'm gonna be boastful. I'm not gonna lie to you. I don't lie because I agree. I know who I serve. The difference between Allah and Jesus is. Allah is that God. Jesus is God. How? You may ask me, how? I'll prove it. Now, I'm coming. Now, Allah, you don't have no proof. Person, you don't have no proof that Allah exists. Muslim, you have no proof that Allah exists. You have no proof that Allah exists because you never heard his voice. No Muslim on earth has heard Allah's voice. How can Allah be God if you cannot hear his voice? Oh yes, I listen to a lot of Muslims. You can pray for 20 years, Allah will not hear your prayers. That is not God. Now, you cannot come up here and lie to the world that Allah is Jesus. That Jesus is a servant of Allah. That Jesus is a servant of Allah. Jesus is not serving of nobody. He's God in the flesh. He's God in the flesh. Okay? He left his throne. He left his worship. He left everything in heaven. He was the word that created the heaven and the earth. He was the word that created the angels. He was the word that formed the earth. He was the word that created the man from the dust of the ground. It was that word that became flesh that dwelt amongst men. Your Quran said Jesus is the word of Allah. Then he named it. Okay. It also said Jesus is the spirit of Allah. I won't go through that. And that was a different story. Now, today, I want to compare your Allah with Jesus. Two different. So Allah can never be God. Two different things. Then in your Quran said, Allah is a deceiver. Not just any deceiver, but the father of deceit. Didn't your Quran say Allah is the father of deceit? That's why your prophet Muhammad said, if I have one foe in paradise, I'm afraid that Allah is going to throw me down to hell because Allah is a deceiver. Didn't your Quran say it? It is in your Quran, it is written in your Quran. He's the father of deceit. Now, God can never be a deceiver. God can never be a deceiver. A deceiver means a liar. God can never be a deceiver. Then your Quran say, Allah don't love. Huh? Then your Quran say, Allah does not love. Allah don't love. The reason Allah created humanity is to be his slave. It's in the Quran. It is written in your Quran. Don't tell me I'm not lying. It's in your Quran, right? Allah created humanity according to the Quran to be his slave. That's what he don't love. You will pray and pray and pray and pray and pray and pray for salvation. If Allah decided not to take it to heaven, you're not going to go to heaven. Decided not to take it to heaven is right. He can say it to hell anything he want to say it to hell. I don't care how faithful you are. Then your Quran said that. Now, you cannot compare him with the Almighty God. Our God is love. My God is love. That's why he left his heaven and come down to he disgraced himself as a human being. He came as a human being to die, to bring us back to the Father. Jesus is the Son of God. Don't forget, he's the Son of God. He's the Son of God. He's God in the flesh. You cannot tell me say he's a Muslim. That's a blaspheme. I don't blame you. I blame all the Christians that have been deceived. Oh yes, I don't blame. Listen. I don't blame Muslim. Honestly, I don't blame you. Honestly, I don't blame you. Okay. All you try to do is to win souls. You try to win souls to holla. That's what you're doing. So that's what making all the big boy. You try to win souls. You try to win Christians. But those Christians that convert to Muslim, they are stupid. Honestly, they are stupid because any Christian that convert to another religion, me, you don't know your God. You don't know who you are serving. Because if you know who you are serving, what are you looking for out there? Is love you're looking for? Is happiness, is peace? Your God is peace, is love, is all in all. He said, I am the I am. Where else are you looking for? Because those Christians that are being converted because they don't have personal relationship with the God. Number two reason, because they don't know the Bible. You see, if you don't know your Bible, if you don't have a relationship with Christ, you'll be easily deceived. You'll be easily deceived. Or if you have a personal relationship with Christ and you don't know your Bible, you'll be easily deceived also. You'll be deceived. It doesn't matter if you have a relationship with Christ or not. The main reason, know your Bible, know the word of God, so you won't be deceived. That Bible is one of the biggest deceptions that is going to deceive Christianity. Believe me. I'm not here to make video and argue with Muslim. I'm here to clear their eyes to understand. That's a blaspheme. You cannot blaspheme against Almighty God. That Bible is blaspheme. As a Muslim that come, I just ask you guys questions. Okay. Don't be offended by my questions though. It was because I'm asking you. Okay. You can respond to me in a video. You can test me, whatever it is. We can talk about it because you don't know who I serve. And I know who you are serving. You see, that's a two different thing. You don't know who I'm serving. You don't know my God, but I know who your God is. I know who your God is. I'm not being boastful. I'm not telling. That's I'm telling the truth. I know who your God is. But you don't. You have no idea who I'm serving. You don't know who Jesus is. That's why you call him your prophet. Because if you know who Jesus is, you're not calling your prophet. You're not calling your prophet. If you know who Jesus is, you're not calling your prophet or a servant of Allah. If you know who Jesus is, you're not calling your servant of Allah because he's God. God bless you.